We are currently at one of my favorite CharyMo stations, charging at a whopping about 32 kilowatt right now. I'm putting some power into a nice cold battery. Well, it was cold. I've hinted to it before, but I got a new little device here, and you can see it flashing right here. And it's a neat little thing here, and let's turn on some night vision. And let's take a little peek. So we're going to go with night shot. And still not enough. Well, what it is, I have this neat little dongle here, thanks to some very awesome Tesla Motors Club members. And this converts the CAN bus to OBD reader, to reader. And that's a low power Bluetooth transmitter, which then transmits up here to my phone using a currently closed but available Tesla Spy app. Now, this isn't Tesla Spy. This is Remote S. Because I just wanted to see. We're charging at a 33 kilowatt right now, and that's because the voltage in the battery is so low. So, as you can see, we're just kind of putting away here. So, we are going to open up Tesla Spy. And there we go. We have lots of data goodies. And as you can see, it shows some interesting data that you don't normally get to see about your car. One of those being, and the most important, is the battery pack health for the most part. If you look at the top, it starts off with my VIN number, which, big deal, everybody knows that are in anyways, and then it shows the voltage of the pack. Now, usually you get to see the pack voltage if you're supercharging. Well, this lets me see the voltage of the pack even when I'm not supercharging. You can see the negative 95.3 amp. The negative means power is going into the battery. If there wasn't a negative on it, then that would mean I'm drawing power from the battery. Now, this is one thing I'm not too sure on, but you see where it says pack, it says 80.9, and then remaining 16.6. Now, what I'm not sure of yet, and I'm still experimenting on this, is does that 80.9 with a 16.6, now 16.7 kilowatt hour remaining, is that before or the actual pack capacity, or is that the pack capacity after after the Tesla chops the little bit of overhead for anti-battery pack tricking? Vinny. Yes, it's been a while since I've had a Vinny talker in the car for a video. Come on, go back, sit in your seat. So, one way I'm going to be able to find that out, and I've asked a few times, I haven't gotten any responses from anybody as to this yet, but the last test, my Bluetooth dongle had crapped out on me. It was a DOA, it worked for about a day, so I sent that one back, and I just got the new one back, the new one yesterday, so I finally get to test it now. The other one read last week, 81.1 kilowatt hour battery pack capacity. Now, that would go hand in hand with my current rated range of about 280 miles, which would show the loss of capacity. Though it also would go hand in hand with what the usable capacity is of the battery pack, according to Jason Hughes, who hacked the BMS and got pulled some actual numbers straight from the BMS system. Now you should also see then my the mileage on the car. Also see the discharge and charge numbers there, which are supposed to be the lifetime charge and discharge of the vehicle. Now I don't know if that's for the whole vehicle, even if you have a battery change, or if that's reported by the battery pack, so the life of the battery pack. Personally, the numbers don't quite add up. Oh, Mike Kaminsky. Kim Koski, excuse me. I always pronounce your name wrong. So, I mean, discharge should actually technically be lower than charge because, you know, you do get self-discharge of a battery pack. So I don't know if those numbers are reversed. It says charge 11, or discharge. So we got 12.868 megawatts. So if we go down to the screen here and go to my trips, trip A on this car is the lifetime consumption of the vehicle. So since I got it, this is with about 40 miles on the car, I think. That is 9.881 megawatts. So, I mean, we got a 3 megawatt difference. That's a pretty big difference. So, I'm not sure exactly how accurate that is. Now we get to the good stuff. All right. This represents the 96 bricks in my battery pack. So, how the car is arranged. There's some 7,200 and something 18650 lithium cells in my car. Each of those cells is placed into a brick. Then there's multiple bricks per sheet. There are 16 sheets of cells in the car, 16 modules if you will. So, what this shows me is what the voltage of each individual are 96 bricks of cells, because each brick has a nominal voltage of about 3.7, fully charged is about 4.2 volts. When you add up all the bricks together, you come out to about 403 volts, roughly, which is what the car reports as fully charged when you're done charging at a supercharger. So this shows us what each of those bricks, how balanced each of them are. Right now, I have a 17 millivolt difference between the lowest and the highest brick. The lowest brick has 3.648 volts. The highest brick is 3.664, with an average of 3.657. Very interesting. And it's actually a little more off than it is when it's at rest. So you can see it's slightly different for the bricks, a little bit of wavy, haven't quite figured everything out. But this is the first time I've been able to see it while it's been doing a DC fast charge of some sort. But if we, whoops, zoom out a little bit. So you can zoom in. Night mode. Not sure which is easier for you guys to see, night mode. Yeah, let's leave it on night mode. Vinny, you got your shoesies off. Alright, so right now my state of charge is 25%. Let's quickly jump and see what I'm charging at now. 34 kilowatt. Okay. So now, right now, I'm still exploring the program quite a bit. Now that I got the dongle back, I can continue to explore again. But so far, there's basically three usable screens for me at this moment. This one gives me the voltage histogram, gives a little bit better idea of the balance of the pack. So this is showing me that there is a 16 millivolt difference. Of course, with the minimum, average, and maximum. And after, you know, in the morning, after it's been sitting, charge complete, depending, no matter what, you know, the charge rate that I have selected is, it's usually about a 5 or 6 millivolt difference, meaning my pack is really, really balanced. So it's quite possible that I'm going to have to rewrite the book on balancing the Tesla battery pack by doing 100% charges. So keep that in mind. I mean, I wrote the book on balancing your battery pack at superchargers. And, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's working, but the theory behind it might need to change. And look at that. We're at 26%. Car is now reporting that we have a rated range of 62 miles. Still about 15 millivolts. Let's switch screens one more time now. We'll come back. And here is my battery pack temperature. Before we started our drive to get here, we had a few different errands to run. We were at about 24 degrees Fahrenheit of our battery pack. Now we're at 66 degrees Fahrenheit for the hottest cell, or excuse me, the hottest module. Now, there appears to be two temperature sensors per module. And so a total of, what is that, 32 sensors, because there's 16 modules in my 90D. Now, one thing that's a little strange is this one always seems to report quite a bit hotter than the others. I mean, we're not talking that big of a difference. We're talking 67 degrees compared to about 63.2. So the difference isn't as big as what the chart makes it look like. But we're still talking, we'll say 65. We're still talking about 2.2 degrees hotter than the other sensors. So I don't know. I guess in a way that might be a good thing in the summertime, because then the car might trigger the act of cooling sooner. But in the wintertime, it might let it charge when the batteries are still... Actually, no. It should be just fine, because in the wintertime, it wouldn't let you charge until the coldest cell is up to the designated temperature for charging. So, like I say, this is still a work in progress, ongoing and ongoing, still learning. There's a few other screens, and there's lots of different options I haven't even started to touch yet. So, there's a lot of good information that I will be adding to my every 1,000-mile range updates. And as you see, I just hit the 26,000 last weekend. And we have... where's your shoes? Benny, say hi. He's chilling out on Mama Lay's lap. He's got his little footsies. Say hi, Mama.
Say hi.
Hi, Benny.
Come and say hi.
Hi. High five.
Yeah,
here. Funny little Mia. So we'll be adding that to do my range updates. Jumped up, and now we're back to 15 millivolts. I can't wait to see what this looks like when we plug into the supercharger on Friday night. I mean, that should be something fairly impressive. We now have 68 rated miles into the car. Let's see what we're charging at now. I'm curious on how high the voltage will jump up when the car's charging at 98 kilowatt, since that seems to be the maximum I can hit ever since they came out with firmware 8. So we're still at 33 kilowatt hour, or excuse me, kilowatt charge rate. It's not too good. But I should be able to hit about 44 on this station. This is one of those Nissan Slims. I don't know if I'm either getting voltage limited right now or temperature limited. We're charging at 94 amp. And I think the station goes up to 120 amp. So I think I'm temperature limited yet. But I really shouldn't be. I'm well above the... I'm well above the temperature rating for supercharging. 70.2, 66.4, and that one just keeps going up. See that? So that's my introduction to Tesla Spy. You will not see that in the App Store. It's currently only available on test flight. But you're welcome to check out the forum link in the Tesla Motors Club forum. Just search for TM-SPY. It's available for Android and iOS, and there's a lot of discussions going on right now about it. So we're going to stick around until we have 100 miles in our battery pack, and then we're going to continue the drive home. Good night, folks. Smile, cheese.